Elizabeth Frost, Technical Specialist Honeybees for Department of Primary Industries, based here at Tocal College. Today we'll run through how to do a soapy water wash for Varroa detection. You'll need your personal protective equipment, your bee suit, gloves or no gloves, depending on your style of beekeeping. You'll need your smoker and your hive tool. You'll need a tub to collect the bees in, a half cup measure to scoop a measured amount, so half cup is 300 bees. You'll need your receptacle in which your soapy water and your bees are going. So soapy water gets collected in the solid container. The perforated container allows the free movement of your soapy water into those bees that you collected. And most importantly, you'll need your soapy water. So you'll need a low sudsing soap for this. And at small quantities, you'll need 150 ml of water and about a half teaspoon per single hive sample. And you can scale that up depending on the number of hives you have to do. We'll conduct a soapy water wash to monitor Varroa mites. So we've already smoked our hive. We've taken any supers off that don't have brood to go directly down into the brood nest, the area of the hive that has brood frames, because that is what we will need to take our sample of bees from. Seeing as Varroa is most highly present in the brood nest. So we want a frame that's got a mix of open and capped brood, and this one will do us just fine. Having a really good look for the queen, just scanning that frame very carefully, and I don't see her, but I'll be able to check again when I shake the bees into my sample tub just here. So I've got my soapy water washer at the ready and my half cup for sampling my 300 bees. Shaking that frame, I'll put that aside and have another really good look for the queen against this my solid tub background. And I sure am not seeing her there. So I'll shake the bees down to the corner, grab my half cup or 300 bees, close that quickly, and then I'll get into my sample shaking routine, which is shaking for 15 seconds, three times. So this is the first 15 seconds. And you wanna make sure if you use visual aids, you've got your glasses on for when that 15 seconds is over, you'll open up that sample and have a look underneath. And I'm seeing two mites in the sample so far. So that's shake one, 15 seconds. So we've seen two mites in the first shake. I've put that back together. We'll shake it for the second time for another 15 seconds. And again, we'll take the bee sample out to have a look. Yep, still two Varroa mites there, and now we move on to our third and final shake for 15 seconds. Having a look. Still only seeing two Varroa mites in that sample. And at this point, I can close up the hive, take this sample away, and dispose of it accordingly, recording my two mites found in that sample in my soapy water wash and keeping that in my records.